What's up, guys? It's been a while since I have done a black and white vlog, and a lot of people seem to like it. I wish I had a better themed video topic, but I don't. I felt back home, back in the office, good to be home from LA. It was a lot of fun, but wasn't my favorite memory of traveling. And I'll explain why. A lot of people saw last night that I tweeted out that Theory, or Dylan, his last match with TK, or his last tournament, would be PAX. And then right after that, Formal tweeted out that he would be a free agent for the rest of the 2014 season after PAX. And a lot of people thought it was an April Fool's joke. It wasn't at all, and I guess I owe you guys some answers, because I've had hundreds of tweets asking me, concerned fans, and I want to say really quick, you guys are amazing. All the tweets and posts and everything throughout the weekend of the tournament, even after we got put out, the support from you guys is just phenomenal, so thank you for that. And I want to give you guys some closure on what's actually going on. Sorry, I'm a little nasally. Pick something up. Trying to hit that emergency as hard as I can so I don't go down for the count. So wanted to do a vlog, let you guys know what's up, where Team Caliber stands, what we're doing moving forward. So I'll start with Formal. I didn't really have the gut feeling that Formal was really in it for this team. He's a good dude. Formal's a great guy. He's a hell of a talent. One of the best shots I've ever seen. But at this point, and this is just my opinion, I think Formal's out for Formal. He's trying to find the best place for him and the best opportunities for him. And there's nothing wrong with that. If that's what he's about, that's what he's about. But for Team Caliber, it's always been about being a team, a cohesive unit, and not really individual player. Right now, he's an individual. He's an individual slayer. So he decided that he was going to go elsewhere, and he announced that right after I announced about Theory. So good luck to him. Hope he finds a spot that works for him. We really honestly had a gut feeling that he wasn't going to stick around anyway. Now with Dylan, Theory, that's a way different story. A lot of you know, me and him are pretty close, and not just with the team, but got to know him. He's a good guy. And I didn't see that one coming, to be honest with you. He didn't want to be the captain. He felt like he's not the vote. He didn't want to be a vocal leader in game. That's not his style. And he just felt like it wasn't going to work with what we have. So he decided that after PAX, he's going to go do something else. Not going to lie, I was pretty gutted about it. But in the end, you can't pick people's decisions or life choices for them. They have to make their own. So good luck to you, Dylan. I wish the best for you. I hope it all works out for you and you get what you're looking for. I do want to say, a lot of people are like, oh, wow, you don't place in the top three, one tournament, and your team falls apart. And I'm not going to lie. You're right. You're absolutely right. We've placed all but one LAN in 10 months, top two or top three. And that one LAN was a top four. Everything else has been second and third place. And we get to champs, and we get top 16. We play Optic. We lose, we go to the loser's bracket, we play Envy first round, and we lose. And all I'm going to say is that life's full of roadblocks. Life's full of obstacles that you have to persevere and go over. And Formal and Theory, I guess they decided that they wanted to go elsewhere. So it is what it is. Now, let me talk about the positives. Sharp and Gujar. Start with Gujar. Gujar is going to be with Team Caliber. He's not going anywhere. And every good team has a selfish slayer role. And what that means is you let somebody loose and they play selfish. They play for kills. They play to win gunfights. And you see it with Karma from Cole. You see it with Skump from Optic, and just down the line. But we kind of had two of those, and it wasn't really working. You have Formal, and then Gunjar is also that type of player. Gunjar has a lot more in-game knowledge than Formal. He has a lot more experience, and he's pretty versatile. He can go back and forth with the AR and the SMG. But they play that same type of style, so that wasn't really working for what we need. So in a way, that's a good thing. So we've got Gunjar there, and then what I'm excited about is Sharp. Here's the deal. Right after the tournament, I tried to calm the guys down. We went 8 and tried to just take the edge off. And Sharp basically told us, me and Koss, that he was TK all day. No matter what happened, he was here, and we were going to persevere through it. And to me, that trumps stats. That trumps skill. It trumps everything to me. And I'm not saying Sharp's very skilled. Sharp's an amazing guy, player. He's the epitome of what a Call of Duty pro should be, in my mind. And when he did that, and I knew that he was dedicated, I knew it was going to be all right. So, basically, here's what's happening. Team Caliber's looking for 2. Those 4 guys are going to go do packs. Who knows what's going to happen with that tournament. There's only 6 teams. I believe it's 1 and done. It's a 1-day deal. Hopefully, they go win it. But moving forward after that, it's going to be Sharp and Gunjar. It is Sharp's team. Sharp is the team captain. He's going to be the vocal leader. He's going to be the in-game leader. And he accepts that role. Me and him had a talk. And he's excited about that role. He's ready to go. And we didn't really come into champs prepared. And you could say, oh yeah, you guys went to the UGC thing and you scrammed and blah blah blah. But we didn't come mentally prepared. We came thinking that skill alone was going to get it done. And there's a lot more to it when you're on this level of competition. This is the top of the line when it comes to Call of Duty. And if you're not ready mentally and ready strategically, which we weren't, especially in SMD, we were just flying by the seat of our pants, and ready as a team and everybody bought in and have that in-game vocal leader to calm the waters when things are rough and to bring you back down when you're getting too hyped, when you think nobody in the world can beat you, and just keep you balanced, you're not going to win. And you saw this weekend the teams that did well, they had all of those factors. They had a map, they had a mission of what they were doing and their strategies, they had an in-game leader, and they had camaraderie, they had team. I even saw to the point with some of these teams like Envy, a type of brotherhood, and that's what we want as well. And I thought we had it, but apparently we don't. So moving forward, this vlog's getting really long. Moving forward, it's Sharp and Gunjar. They're going to take their time with us, and they're going to scream, and we're going to find the right fit for us. Whether that be, we've never been known for having the big names. We had Clay for 1 tournament. That was a big name, I guess. But we're not worried about the big names. We're worried about the 2 pieces that can fit into the puzzle, that fit in with exactly what we're looking for. And I can tell you, if you're a TK fan, which I know a lot of you are that follow me, don't stress. It's going to be fine. Just trust me. I need you to trust me. And all the comments, everybody, doesn't matter who we put out, you guys are always TK fans, so on and so forth. That's awesome. Thank you. But we're not going to miss a beat. We missed a beat with COD Champs. Mistakes were made, and this is what is happening to remedy those mistakes. It's Sharp. Sharp's taking a leadership role. I'm really comfortable with that. I think that's the best thing for us. And we'll see what happens. So follow Team Caliber on Twitter, and we'll let you know when we fill out the roster. Going to PAX, it's the same 4 that were at COD Champs, but after that, it's over. And then we're going to roster up and power through this season, whatever tournaments we have coming up. So that is your update, guys. This was a really long vlog. Sorry about that. Sorry it wasn't more upbeat, but I wanted to give you guys the information And so you're not in the dark. No April Fool's joke or anything like that. I wish it was to a degree, but then again, I'm excited for the change. Hindsight's 2020, and looking back, I think this is what we need. I really do. And not everything happens for a reason, obviously, and this happened for a reason, and I think we're going to be better off for it. I really do. I can honestly say that. So I will see you guys later. And that's it. I'm out of here.